See, I have asked you before only. You give me your instructions. What is it that you want me to do? So I can do that only, right? So we'll be discussing everything. This is one chapter that you will have to make efforts to read. And not only once, but many times, because it is not a story. It is an autobiography, and it is a very meaningful experience. Now, when we read this chapter, Long Walk to Freedom. In this chapter, we're talking about one is the ceremony. Yes? The new government formation, right? And it's a historic moment. What is the historic moment? What is the historic moment? A new democracy, right? And of course, the government of the people of South Africa duly elected. It is also about discussing discrimination. What kind of discrimination did Nelson Mandela and the other leaders and his other contemporaries had to suffer during their lifetimes? On the basis of color, right? And the race that they belong to. What is the practice called? Apartheid. Yes, apartheid. Yes, so it was there. And have you read any other chapter where someone was discriminated because of the race they belong to, or because of the country they belong to? Yes? Yeah, so we've read about Wanda Petronsky. Yes? We have read about Anne Frank also, right? Yes, Wanda Petronsky in 100 Dresses. And we have, yes, Nishtha, absolutely correct. We're talking about the 100 Dresses. And yes, apartheid we're talking about, over discrimination on the basis of color. One thing is there, that all races are equal. If everyone is equal, then why do we discriminate? Why does this discrimination happen? Why do you think it happens? Okay, supposing if Nelson Mandela and Wanda Petronsky were going to have a conversation, would have, imagine that situation. Both of them faced discrimination, right? And like, of course, Anne Frank, we talk about an extreme case there, that how her family had to go into hiding, right? And to save themselves. And there were so many that they were, taken away to the concentration camps in large numbers. You've read about that. And it is such a sad moment, when you reflect upon it, that how can people be like this? Now, when you talk about Nelson Mandela and Wanda Petronsky, supposing if they were to have a conversation, what would they, there's something in common for them to discuss? Discrimination? Yes, Amritpal, can you stand up? Yeah, Simon, stand up, please. If you had to discuss your experience, right? Yeah, your Wanda is Nelson Mandela. Yeah, she's Wanda Petronsky. Both of them faced discrimination if they had to talk. So you can just talk about that. Was it a nice experience? What is it that you want? Don't answer me yes and no. Give me nice, proper answers. Was, say, it a lesson that you wanted everybody to know about you? Why is it so difficult for people to accept someone who looks different, who has a different name? Why are we so happy in this little well or that little hole of ours that we don't want to widen our horizons and widen our perspectives? Yes. So, and then Nelson Mandela is going to talk about that. See, I decided to fight for my people. I decided to fight for my country, right? Okay, and you were there, of course, you forgave those girls who were bullying you, who were teasing you. So you were also there, right? So you can talk about that. So if you are, yes, come on, let's have that conversation. Yes, we can have someone taking the interview. Why? You have a common ground to discuss. Okay, sit down, sit down, sit down. And Hardik will be Peggy. Yes. So here it is. Yes. So now we have a few examples where you have read about. So discrimination, it can happen in many forms, right? So on the basis of color, on the basis of caste, on the basis of the community you belong to, the country you come from, the religion you follow, people need any reason to make you feel different, right? The biggest problem is to accept. Now, what was there about this practice that made the rulers, that made the people stand up and raise a voice against this inhuman practice? Why did Nelson Mandela realize that I want freedom in all spheres of life? It is not only, yes, that when he was a child and he would go riding, you know, like there under the stars, or maybe going for a swim or running in the fields and all. What was it? What kind of freedom did he want to have? What kind of freedom did he want to have? He wanted complete freedom. He wanted that when I grow up and when, you know, like, yes, the people, the children of my country, race, they grow up, they should have that freedom to go wherever they want to. They should have the freedom to follow any occupation they want to. There should be no limits or restrictions on their dreams. So when someone is there telling you that you are different and limiting your movement, limiting your freedom, right? So how did he and the other leaders, they suffer because they had decided to take this momentous decision? How did they suffer? How did the family suffer? Yes, Nishtha, absolutely right. Freedom from discrimination. How did they suffer? How did the family suffer? Because Nelson Mandela realized his obligation. One was his obligation towards his country, other towards his family. And if he decided to raise his voice, or if he decided to fight for equality, would he be able to do his duties towards his family? No, because he was there then fighting for his country, and he was always treated as a criminal, right? Sent to jail so many times, the longest time he has spent in jail, right? And of course, he does say that he had to give up, you know, like his duty towards his family, because he thought that naturally fighting for his country, for his countrymen, was more important, right? And what about that ceremony? What was so beautiful about that ceremony? Can anybody just tell me? Today, I'm just discussing the summary. Read the chapter thoroughly. Tomorrow, we'll do the multiple choice questions. Yes, how it was. What had happened because of this practice of apartheid? His country had been alienated. Yes. So the leaders from other countries, they did not accept such a practice. And as a result, yes, so that alienation had happened. Now, at this momentous occasion, he said it was a red letter day. Right? And it was a very important day. Right? Please remember the day. When was it? Talks about the building where it took place, the Grindstone Amphitheater where it took place, and the leaders from all the countries were there, and the army generals and all the high officials coming and meeting him. And what was their position? What was their behavior a few weeks or months ago? How did these people behave? Did they support them? No, they were against him, and they were there with the government of that time. They would send him to jail, right? They were not supporting him. They were not with him, right? So here it is, you know, like he's telling that how things have changed and how people have come to realize that, see, what was happening was wrong, okay? And of course, people from another country coming and controlling someone and telling them that you are not as good as us, right? You are not our equal. You will stay in separate places. Your jobs are this. Your work is this. You are not like us. And discriminating on the basis of the color of skin is something so inhuman, right? So then he talks about the ceremony. What about the jets flying over? Yes. And the color of the flag. Yes. And his daughter was there with him and all the leaders there. And yes, he felt right. So it was a very, very important occasion. Then how does he pay tribute to all the leaders? How did he? By thanking them? Yeah, that's so nice. So easy. What about the leaders who had given up their lives for this whole cause, who did not see this day? Yes, he was remembering him and he felt it right now. I have a big responsibility because he was a representative of all the people who had given up their lives. Right? So many of them who had given up their lives and he was there as a representative. What was the cause that they had died for? The freedom of the country, for the equality of the people? Right? Yes. So he was standing there and making everyone, you know, like, or making himself also realize that I have to live up to the ideals that these people laid down their lives. It's a big responsibility. Yes. Now he wants a freedom of all kinds for the people. So he does not want his people to suffer in any way. Yes. Now they're equal. They're all the same. They can go anywhere. Right. But he also wants there should be no one should be poor, right? And of course, once again, no one should, you know, have that kind of those social differences which happened earlier, right? So this is, I would say, basically a summary about the chapter. And of course, there is a scope of so many multiple choice questions from this, right? Now, before we proceed with that, can any one of you just tell me, what are the qualities of Nelson Mandela that made him different from the rest? Yes? His determination, okay. Patriotism, yes. So he also felt sorry for them also. Like, see that what is it that makes them behave in this way, right? Yes, he wanted a realization that it is not one person who is suffering, but others also. He talks about the oppressor, right? And he wants, you know, liberation for them also. They should realize that they are doing something wrong. Do you think this kind of, yes, he had the confidence, he had the courage to raise his voice. That's very, very important. So for a leader, naturally, it is there. What are the qualities we talk about? It is courage, determination, what else? Hard work. He was a patriotic person, of course, yes. Patriotism. Then he should have faith in the cause that he is fighting for. He should have the courage to keep up the faith in his followers also. You should not disappoint them, right? That is very, very important. And do you think Nelson Mandela was able to do that? Yes. Do you think people can relate with a leader like someone who has suffered the same things as them? Or maybe someone who is already experiencing freedom and has all the facilities and all the, you can say, luxuries. Who do people relate more to? Someone like them or someone who is an outsider to this whole problems? Someone like them, someone who has suffered as much as them, right? Okay. And yes, here he does talk about, what do you think there? Have you heard about slavery? Yes? What is slavery? What is slavery? So people, they're working on, you can say, for people, you know, like on the plantations, the mines, right, the fields, they're working for in their homes. And do you think these people had any rights? No. They had any dignity? Do you think they were getting, yes, Do you think they were getting any wages? No. Not, you know, it was not something very fixed and right, but it was there. They had to really work hard, but it was not something very regular, right? Then, do you think they ever could dream of freedom? No. So slavery was also a practice that took part, right? And yes, it was there in America, England, many other countries also. Yes, right. So wherever people, you know, like they were treated like what? Bought and sold like cattle. What do you think happens? What do you think goes in the mind of one person when he wants to, you know, treat someone as lower than him, or he considers himself to be superior? What do you think happens in the mind? What makes a person behave like that? They're depressed? Money? What else? Yes? Power? They want to feel powerful? They want to feel stronger? They want to show their superiority? That is why they behave like this, right? So it is like in many ways in life, we are there, you know, the way we behave in society also. So when you are there, like supposing something is happening on the streets, you see someone harassing someone, someone creating a problem for others, will you step in and stop that from happening? Or will you first see, look at that person, oh my God, he looks so big and strong, he'll just give me one punch and I'll fall in the street, so let me go away. But if that person is someone very weak and all, and you feel I can control that person, then you step in. See, these things, they do happen in our mind, right? So it is not everyone who has the courage to raise a voice against any wrongdoing. So here it is, we're just talking about one example, but the thing is that nothing of this sort should ever happen in society, whether it was what happened with Anne Frank, that's maybe the darkest chapter of history, right? What happened with Wanda Petronsky, lack of awareness, and how the child was there shifted from that school so that she would not be bullied or teased because of her name, right? Because of the community she belonged to, why she did not have a regular name like others. Or whether when we talk about Nelson Mandela, how much his people and how much they had suffered, okay? Right. Yes. So let me see if I can share these questions with you and if you're able to get the answers. Yes, all of you, can you see the screen? And those of you who have the books, just go. I'll just read out the questions twice so that those who are here in the class, so they can just listen. Okay, open to the first page of your chapter. Open to the first page. When was the inauguration day? Is it 10th May? Is it 10th March? Is it 20th May or is it 20th March? There's something that he writes about this day. What is it that he writes about this day? Read, what is there about this day? Find out what he has written about it. Okay. It was a celebration of South Africa's first, what kind of government? Listen to the options. Autocratic and racial. Democratic, racial. Democratic, non-racial. Monarch and non-racial. It's not an autocratic government. It is not a monarchy, right? It is not a racial government. Right, so it is non-racial. This is something that they had fought for a long time. How many? Yes. Nelson Mandela was the president, yes. And how many deputy presidents were elected? Who were they? Is the name given? So there were two deputy presidents elected. The clerk, was there one and the other? Okay, these are very simple questions. These are there, you know, just checking your knowledge, right? And as I told you, you'll be getting different kinds of questions also. Now, why did other countries broke off diplomatic relations with South Africa? Why did other countries, yes, Hardik, are you listening? Why did they break off diplomatic relations with South Africa? Because of the white rulers? Because other countries are racial? Because it is a poor country? Or because of the apartheid policy? Yes, absolutely correct. Because it did not support it, so the governments did not have any kind of relation to make the people realize that they are wrong. Okay, right. What change brought international leaders to South Africa? Why have international leaders come to South Africa? Is it the end of apartheid? Humanity brought them there? Peace happening in South Africa? Or was it because of trade negotiations? End of apartheid, a new democratically elected government was in place now. That is why they were there. Those of you who have not read the chapter, please read it. I don't want to see blank looks over here in the classroom. Oh, yeah. We thank all of our distinguished international guests for having come to take possession with the people of our country of what is, after all, a common victory for. I repeat. What is it a common victory for all this that is happening? Justice, peace, human dignity, or all of the above? All of the above. All of the above is there. But, and of course, here you have to be very, very careful of all of the above and both A, B, none, right? Jenny, none of the above options would not be there. It would not be there, okay? No, not generally, you know, because... None of the, you wait for none of the above. None of the above. Okay. What was it that the nation needed to be liberated from? What was the problem there that the nation had to be liberated from? Yes, it was poverty, gender discrimination, deprivation, all of the above. In the end, you know, when he gives his speech, he says that I want freedom, you know, I want equality in all aspects. Yes, so he talks about there should be no inequality related to gender or economic inequality or social injustice happening there. So you have to read this very, very carefully when he talks about his duty, talks about complete freedom. We have achieved our political emancipation. What is the meaning of emancipation, Mehul? What does emancipation mean? Is it freedom from restriction? Is it enslavement? Emancipation. Is it slavery? Is it both two and three, enslavement and slavery? What is emancipation? Emancipation is freedom. Yes, right? Here it is because of freedom from restriction, restriction of movement, restriction of their ambitions and everything. Okay, right. Spectacular array of South African jets was a display of. What was it? How did the South African jets come and they fly above the meeting over there? The ceremony. What did it show? What was it a display of? Was it military's precision? How well they can fly the jets? Look. Was it military's loyalty to democracy? Both A and B? Or none of the above? I've got this option. None of the above also this time. No, it is military's loyalty. More of that. Precision they're supposed to be. This has to be there. When they're putting up that, that is what the military is very, what you can known for, right? So it is a loyalty. Why did they do that earlier? When Nelson Mandela was there fighting for the cause, did the military support him at that time? No. So the military's loyalty is also with the present government, okay? What colors does the new South African flag possess? Look at it. Look, this. This is okay. Knowledge. Knowledge, right? Yeah. Yes. So that was the color of the flag. So what is it? Black, red, green, blue, and gold? Blue? Black, red, yellow, blue, and gold? Black, red, yellow, blue, and gold? Black, red, green, blue, and gold? Orange, black, yellow, blue, silver? Black, blue, violet, saffron, green? First one or second one? Black, red, yellow, blue, gold. Yellow nahi. So it's black, red, green, blue, gold. Sure. Oh, what a confusion. It's simply written over there. When the jets they flew over and the color of the national flag. Just read that. It's given. Yes. Yes, yes. Deprivation means deprived of something. And here, deprivation means to suffer because of the lack of something here. So here he talks about, he does not want his people to suffer because of economic deprivation. No one should be there suffering because of poverty. That is what he means over there. Is it clear now? Yes. Now, the structure they created form the basis of one of the most harshest, most inhumane societies the world has ever known. What structure is Mandela talking about? Who's created that structure? Inhuman structure. Who created it? White people? The racial discrimination against the black skinned? Poverty and suffering? Discrimination against the poor? Or oppression of women? Racial discrimination or domination against the black skin. So he's there talking about that. That was one of the most inhuman practices. Okay? Right.